author connections that you need. How do we connect with readers? The story itself is the most important connection that we can have with our readers, because it's through story that we connect with each other as human beings. The book should be well written and well edited, because your book is how you connect with your reader. It should be properly formatted, it should have a professional cover, and the cover should convey what type of a story is within. So let's begin with the cover. This cover tells you that this is a Western, right? This one goes into a little more detail. This is a Western. We've got gold pieces at the bottom. We have a woman whose hands are tied, cowboy with a gun. This one has a younger heroine. Set on a cruise ship. This is a beach read. So the reader wanders through the bookstore, and the first thing that they see that catches their eye is the cover. And this is true if they're shopping online as well. So your cover needs to be vivid in color, eye-catching, things that draw you in. It needs to stand out, not just in a book size, but in a little tiny square for your mobile readers. So the cover's the first step. Step one, reader sees the cover, it pulls them in. Now what? A good back cover synopsis tells them what the story is about. And it should lead them to open to page one. I'll use this one for example first. Bethany is celebrating her 18th birthday in Hot Springs. If her aunt and uncle have their way, then she will return engaged. Her life has been controlled from the clothes she wears to the food she eats, but she plans to cut off her long hair like other girls and to fly free. Paul chased butterflies when he was young. Now he chases gangsters. Bethany captures his interest like a butterfly, but two other men have determined to catch her, and one is a dangerous gangster. Will she exit her cocoon, find strength, and fly free, or be trapped? So this gives a hint that it's the 1920s. The third step, the book, the cover, third step, is the first sentence. This one, and I keep them short for a reason. Bethany Robinson did not need yet another lecture on being appreciative. So this tells you we're in Bethany's point of view. She's young. I'm going to go to the next one, because I think this is, I use this one when I teach how to step into character and point of view, how to leap in from the first page. But we'll begin with the back cover. Lillian Hayes' fiance, Thomas Shelton, convinced the townsfolk to exchange their gold for his worthless banknotes. After he disappears with the gold, every eye turns to Lillian for answers. Even her cousin Carl insists she knows where the gold is. He's desperate to find it because he's deeply indebted to Kingston, a small-town criminal and owner of the local saloon. Carl will do anything to clear his debt, even torture Lillian for answers. Nick Grace is driving a herd of horses to town when he stumbles across Lillian, branded, strung up over a mine shaft, left to die. All right, that should draw your reader to page one. First sentence, pain erased all sense of time. Boom, you're right in there. Now the next step is that the first sentence must lead your reader to read the second sentence and the third and the first paragraph and the entire page. So let's go a little further. Pain erased all sense of time. Lillian didn't know how long she hung, her muscles exhausted from the strain, her mind full of warnings she was helpless to do anything about. That's the first paragraph. Her throat was raw from screaming before Grady had gagged her. Now the cloth gag stuck to her dry tongue. She squinted through tired eyes at the pail of water sitting by the edge of the mine shaft. She could look right down into it, the water taunting her with how good it looked, how it would taste cool and refreshing as it slid over her cup, down her throat. It would soothe her throat if she could just reach it. But there was no hope of that. They tied her up and left her to die of thirst. And that's page one. Your reader-author connection. There are graduations to this. Of course, you want them to read your entire book. There's an agent whose name is Noah Lukman. He's written a book called The First Three Pages, and it's his premise that you only have three pages in which to grab an agent. Now, agents do this because their time is limited, and they want to pick books that will grab the reader in. If you can't grab them fast and pull them in, you're not going to sell a book. Neither will they. Mickey Spillane said, the first chapter sells the book, the last chapter sells the next book. When your reader buys a book, they come hopeful to the page. Every reader comes hopeful to the page. They want a good read. This is true of reviewers as well, even the snarky ones. We want a good read. We want to be entertained. If you accomplish that, you'll sell your second book and your third, and you'll have a reader for life. And this is how you do it. Your job is to connect with your reader through the story. It's through story that we connect with other human beings. Everyone knows what it is to be thirsty. When you tap into that and you put it on the page and you pull your reader in, they connect. And though you may never meet your reader, you've connected through story. And this is the best of the author-reader connection. Thank you.